माइक्रोस्कोपी, इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोपी मीन्स इट इज ए सिस्टम ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक कॉइल्स एंड हियर दिस इलेक्ट्रॉन बीम इज यूज एज द सोर्स ऑफ इल्यूमिनेशन. ओके सो वाई वी आर यूजिंग इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोपी मीन्स इट इज यूजफुल फॉर स्टडिंग वायरस बैक्टीरिया एंड अल्ट्रा स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ सेल ऑर्गेनेल्स. अल्ट्रा स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ सेल ऑर्गेनेल्स. सो दिस इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोप वॉज डिजाइनड बाई नॉल एंड रस्का इन 1932. सो योर टू टाइप्स ऑफ माइक्रोस्कोप्स आर देयर. वन इज ट्रांसमिशन इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोप एंड अदर वन स्कैनिंग इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोप. सो इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोप वर्किंग प्रिंसिपल इज वेव लेंथ ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स. सो वर्किंग प्रिंसिपल इज वेव लेंथ ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स. This electron beam has a very short wavelength ranging from 0.05 angstroms to 0.005 angstroms. It can magnify the objects up to 2 million times. And this electron microscope present in the works in the vacuum, and these electrons are produced by an electron gun. This electron gun containing a tungsten filament. When this tungsten filament is heated, that's time this electron gun releases the electrons. And here the lenses are used in electron microscopes are called electromagnetic coils. Which lenses used in the electron microscope? It's called electromagnetic coils. Here the two condenser lenses are present in the path of electrons, and the function of these condenser lenses, these electrons turns into a narrow beam and focus on the object. So that means the electrons will be reached to the object. So here the object absorbs the electrons and diffracts the electrons and reflects the electrons and transmits the electrons. So the part of the specimen which transmits the electrons appears. Okay, which transmits the electrons appears bright. Okay, when it will be present on the specimen, the electrons appears as bright color. So here this objective lens collecting the image, and this amplifier lenses magnifying the image size up to 1000 times, and this projector lens producing the image on fluorescent screen. Okay, so here these electrons are released by the electron gun. This electron gun containing tungsten or filament, when this tungsten filament are heated, that time this electron gun released the electrons. So here the lenses are used, two condenser lenses are used. So which are using in the electron microscope, those lenses are called electromagnetic coils. So these condenser lenses are present in the path of the electrons, and so these electrons reach to the object. Thus time this object absorbs the electrons and diffracts and reflects and transmits the electron. When these electrons reach to the specimen, it transmits the electrons appears in bright, and the objective lens is collecting the image, and this amplifier lens magnify the image up to 1000 times, and the projector lens producing the image, and it will be present on the fluorescent screen. It's about the electron microscope. Then next, transmission electron microscope, it's called TEM. So here also electron beam is used, and also electromagnetic coils used as lenses. So when high voltage current is passed through a filament cathode ray tube, that's time this electron beam is produced from the filament. Okay, so when high voltage of current passed through the filament cathode ray tube, this electron beam is produced from the filament. So this electron beam is passed through a specimen stained with metallic gold. Okay, this electron beam is passed through a specimen stained with a metallic gold. That's time the specimen absorbs some rays and reflects and some other rays. Okay, so this specimen absorbs the rays and also reflects the some other rays here. So here how the image is produced means the interaction between specimen and electron beam. Okay, the interaction between specimen and electron beam produces the image of the specimen. So this image collected by the objective lenses and it will be reached to the amplifier. The amplifier function is magnified the image, and it was recorded by a screen camera or photographic plate. So this TEM helps to produce a 2D image. So when high voltage current is passing through the filament cathode ray tube, this time this electron beam is produced from the filament, and when the electron beam is passing through the specimen with is stained metallic gold. Okay, so this time the specimen absorbs the some rays and also reflects the some other rays, and interaction between the specimen and electron beam producing the image of the specimen. This objective lens collecting that image, and also this amplifier helps to magnify the image, and the recorded screen camera, it completely the image is recorded in the screen camera or photographic plate, and it's produced a 2D image. Another one, SIM, scanning electron microscope. So here this electron microscope scans the surface of specimen by passing an electron beam is called scanning electron microscope. So here the electron beam is passing through the surface of specimen and it produces image. So it is very useful to study of cells, membranes, organelles and others. So working principle, when electron beam is focused on the specimen, okay, when electron beam is focused on the specimen, here three types of electrons are produced. One is secondary electrons, another one backscattered electrons, another one characteristic X-rays. Okay, once again, electron beam is focused on the specimen, thus time it produces three types of electrons. One is the secondary electrons, backscattered electrons, and another one characteristic X-ray. So secondary electrons means when the electrons reflected due to the interaction between specimen and surface electrons, these secondary electrons are formed. So reflected due to the specimen interaction between the specimen and also surface electrons. Okay, backscattered electrons means electrons reflected by the sample due to its elastic scattering. So the electrons are reflected by the sample due to its elastic scattering. Another one, characteristic X-rays. So here, these are emitted by the sample when the electron beam removes the inner shells of atom at the surface specimen. Okay, it is emitted by the sample. These electron beam removes in the inner shells of the atoms in the surface specimen. Thus, time these characteristic X-rays are produced. So here, these three, that means this SE and BSE and characteristics X-ray, these three are detected by the specialized detectors. These three are detected by the specialized detectors, and the electronic amplifiers and electronic amplifiers of different kinds are used to measure the electronic signals. Okay, so these electronic amplifiers of different kinds are used to measure the electronic signals. So these electronic signals are converted into bright spots of varying density by a scanning circuit, and it gives the image of the specimen on the screen. So these amplifiers, different kinds of amplifiers we are used, those are collector and scintillator and PMT. These are the amplifiers we are using in the SEM to detect the measure the electric signals. So these electric signals are converted into bright spots, and this will be in the scanning circuit. It produces the image on the screen. It supports the electron microscopy. Thank you. Next one, phase contrast microscope. So phase contrast microscope is a light microscope, and it is an optical instrument. It magnifies the image. And it's a modification of compound microscope. Next, the principle. This phase contrast microscope uses an optical illumination technique. And this microscope separates the background light and the specimen scattering light. It separates the illuminating background light and also the specimen scattering light. And here, this optical illumination technique changes the brightness passing through a transparent specimen in the image. This optical illumination technique changes the brightness passing through a transparent specimen in the image. The change of brightness is called phase shift. So it is not visible. Okay, this phase shift or not visible to the naked eye. Why? Because the changes are very small. Okay, so the next, why we are using phase contrast microscope. It helps to visualize the transparent, colorless, unstained and living biological specimens. So we are using phase contrast microscope for helps to visualize transparent, colorless and unstained living biological specimens. So here, we already discussed it is a modification of compound microscope. So it contains all components of a component microscope. Here, in addition, this annular diaphragm and also this annular phase plate are present in the phase contrast microscope. Remaining five present in the compound microscope. Okay, these two are addition to the phase contrast microscope. So here, the green light is illuminating light that passes. The condenser analysis focused on the specimen by the condenser. So this one is the condenser and this one is the specimen. So this one is the illuminating light. So it passes through the condenser. Here two lights are formed. One is the background light, another one is the specimen scattered light. Okay, so this background light is unaffected light and this one is the affected light. Okay, so here this yellow one is completely specimen scattered light and red one is the background light. So here what is the principle? It separates the illuminating background light and the specimen scattering light. The function of phase contrast microscope is separates the illuminating background light and the specimen scattering light. So here we can observe, so this is the illuminating light and when it passed through the condenser, and here the red one is the background light and this one is the specimen scattered light. So when this illuminating light passing through the condenser, it forms two lights. One is the scattered by the specimen scattered light, another one is the background light. So here the phase differences between the specimen and background light. Okay, specimen and background light, they form final image. So the phase difference between the specimen and background light, these two are forms final image. So here two types of phases are there. One is the positive phase and then one is the negative phase. Positive phase means here the specimen present in the dark color and the background is completely bright color, and when it is the negative phase, here the specimen present in the bright color and the background present in the dark color. So phase contrast microscope, it's a modification of compound microscope and it uses optical illumination technique. This technique helps to change the brightness pass through the transparent specimen, and the change of brightness is called phase shift. This phase shift is not visible for the naked eye. Why we are using this PCM means it helps to visualize the transparent and colorless, unstained and living biological specimens. So here completely seven components are there, and here this illuminating light, when it passes through the condenser, it forms two backgrounds. One is the two lights, one is the specimen scattered light and another one is the background light, and the interaction between specimen and this background light, specimen and this background light, they form a final image. So here two types of phases are there. One is the positive, another one is the negative. So where the specimen is dark in color, it is positive. Where specimen in the bright color, it is the negative one.